welcome back to the fifth Amiibo tournament. I almost lost track of which tournament it was, but yes, this is the fifth one. And last time we did some preliminary matches to see who would be getting into the first round of the bracket, and now we have our 16 teams. I'm going to do 8 of them in this episode, and then I'll be releasing an episode afterwards for 8 more. And they'll be coming at the same time, like within hours of this one. So we're going to go ahead and hop into the Smash here. And we're going to get into these matches. I think the tag team is actually a pretty good idea. Let's go ahead and introduce the first tag team. I'm trying to think here quick. This team is the 6th seed. We felt like both of them are pretty good together, which is why we gave them the 6th seed. We have Lonk from Pennsylvania and Zelda. This is Team Hyrule. We're going to put them on the blue team just because why not? And now their opponents is the 11th seed. The 11th seed team is called Mewtwo Tone, which of course consists of Nostalgia 2, and then also is going to include a Mii that we created. It's our Gunner Mii called Tone Alone. He doesn't actually look like this, but he'll look like what he looks like in battle. We added Tone Alone. He's a kind of a buddy of ours that we hang out with that I hang out with when we play PC games. And he was just the first Mii that came, first person that came to mind when we needed to create a third Mii for the Mii set. But yeah, he's gonna be part of the. You know what? Actually, let's make Mewtwo and Tone Alone part of the blue team. Let's make this team the green team. They're wearing more blue over here. So let's go and pick out the stage. Stage, of course, is gonna be Omega as usual, and we're going to Midgar. And remember, it's still gonna be a 5-minute match. Oh, very exciting. You know, you see there, now you see the reason why we put him in blue. He's wearing a lot, Tone is wearing a lot of blue, and Nostalgia 2 also wearing a lot of blue. So probably just best to put them together in blue. Now, I'm not quite sure how Tone Alone's gonna do in this type of match because, well, he has been trained by just pretty much Jigglypuff, and that's it, but he's actually done pretty well for himself, so it'll be very interesting to see how he does here. So far, it's actually kind of close. There's more damage on Lonk and Zelda, but they're more endurance. So, but Lonk is gonna get killed first, and Tone is gonna get the first kill. That's pretty interesting. Nostalgia 2 is going to toss Zelda out of the stage, so slight lead right now for Mewtwo Tone. And another kill for Nostalgia 2, gets rid of Lonk again. Probably isn't a good sign for Team Hyrule here. Finally, Nostalgia 2 is going to go flying, that kill is going to go to Zelda. And there goes Tone for the first time, also eliminated by Zelda. I expect this one to be kind of a back and forth one. It looks pretty close already. A double kill right there. Lonk putting in one more nice big hit to eliminate both of them. This one is pretty close. I would not mind seeing, there goes Zelda again, eliminated by Nostalgia 2. I wouldn't mind seeing Mewtwo Tone win the 11 seed over the 6 seed. It makes sense. Definitely a close battle so far. They're just kind of going back and forth trading hits against each other. And trading kills as well. So well over half the time has gone by now, and I still have no idea who I think is going to win. I'm not keeping track of the scores on the bottom for each individual character, so it's just kind of like we're going to get surprised if it is really close. For those of you also wondering how sudden death works with tag team, all members of the team are in, and then whoever is the last one standing wins. Saw Zilla get eliminated there, and there goes Lonk again. There goes Tone eliminated by Zelda. And there goes Nostalgia 2. So Zelda doing a lot more killing than anyone else. Still very close. I cannot tell. It was a good recovery there by Tone. But that jumped right into Lonk. And Lonk killed him. Lonk is not going to be able to recover from Nostalgia 2's attack, so Nostalgia 2 being another kill. Tone's doing a good job landing a lot of attacks to do a lot of damage, and he's going to kill Zelda right there. About 30 seconds left. Of course, the winning team will move on to the second round. The losing team is going to be eliminated because it's a single elimination tournament. Another good kill there by Lonk. That kind of held Mewtwo in the her attack, and then Lonk finished it off. 10 seconds left. Alright, so who's the winner? We got a tiebreaker, sudden death. Let's see who's going to win it. Well, both of them kind of just jumped into the attacks, but nonetheless, Team Hyrule is going to win in sudden death. That was a close one, and it was an exciting one. Let's go ahead and take a look at the stats here. 4-4 for Lonk and Zelda. Each did the same amount of work, pretty much. Nostalgia 2 had more kills, Tone had more deaths, but it evened out to 0-0, so they went to a tiebreaker, but Team Hyrule was able to pull it out. That was pretty exciting. That was very exciting. So Team Hyrule will be advancing to the second round. We got that figured. So we're going to go ahead and remove all of these guys, and then we're going to move on to find out who's facing Team Hyrule in the next round. We got a match between the 3 seed and the 14 seed. We got the 3 seed team here. It's called the Bosses because they're the bosses of 2 very popular game series. We got Mr. Boozer and Captain Ganon. Very good team right here. We're going to put them on the red team just because Boozer's red. Why not? And they're going to be facing off against some subspace buddies. 2 unlikely subspace buddies. You're going all the way back to Brawl. For the Subspace Emissary storyline, we're putting together Captain Falcon and Charlie. That'll be very interesting to see how these two work together as a tag team, especially after that awkward encounter they had in Subspace Emissary. But let's go ahead and pick out the stage. Stage is going to be Pyrosphere. Really curious to see how it's going to work with Captain Falcon kind of just being one to run into the fray, whereas Charlie's kind of like, I'll sit around and wait for someone else to attack me first, especially with 2 people that are extremely powerful right here. Wouldn't be surprising to see that stall strategy work for Charlie and Captain Falcon. Captain Falcon is also extremely fast now, but Captain Ganon going to throw in the first kill by elbowing Captain Falcon to oblivion. Oh, but there's a nice strong punch that puts a lot of damage on Boozer and Ganon. And there goes Charlie. I think Ganon and Boozer might have this on lock because it takes a lot to eliminate both of them. They both have great endurance, they both can probably go well to 200 or 300 damage and still recover. See, both of them well high up there, well over 100. Oh, Captain Falcon with a Falcon Punch to eliminate Captain Ganon right there. Very well-timed Falcon Punch. Both of them are stunned. But Captain Falcon is still going to recover. He actually has improved jump is the stat that he changed to from being no improvements. Oh, but a double elbow there by Ganon. You can eliminate both members of the blue team. There goes Boozer for the first time eliminated by Captain Falcon. Captain Falcon doing a lot of the work for the blue team. Oh, that Pikmin's gonna hurt. Oh, and Ganon barely recovering from that purple Pikmin hit. That purple Pikmin hit was definitely pretty painful. Falcon was hiding in there between the two big guys. There goes Captain Ganon again, eliminated by Captain Falcon. Charlie yet to get a kill. Warlock Blade, way out of range for Ganon there. Good recovery by Captain Falcon. It's gonna hurt Boozer a little bit. Oh, Charlie's gone. There goes Captain Falcon as well. The bosses, ruling and grueling. Captain Ganon has some really high damage, but Mr. Boo's gonna eliminate Charlie again. Oh, a Falcon Punch almost lands, but Ganon's able to dodge out of the way just in time. Oh, nice stomp right there. Captain Falcon eliminates Captain Ganon. We're seeing the best of Captain Falcon versus Captain Ganon here. Falcon got thrown, does the Falcon yes off of Ganon, but Boozer's gonna eliminate him. About a minute 20 remaining in this bout, and it looks pretty obvious that Boozer and Ganon are kicking some butt, and they're probably going to win this bout. There goes Boozer, though, so maybe a chance for comeback. It'd be very interesting, though, because that would mean Link and Zelda of Team Hyrule will be facing off against Ganon. It'd be like kind of like a storyline, and then some random Turtle Koopa dude from another dimension comes to help Ganon. Captain Falcon with a nice kick there at the edge to eliminate Ganon. There goes Charlie again by Boozer. I've really enjoyed the battle between the captains here, Ganon and Falcon. Oh, that was a nice hit. Captain Falcon had his shield broken. He just fell, but Charlie actually got slung on those attacks. Ganon and Falcon have been doing pretty much even amount of work, but there's Captain Falcon with another kill. He's having to be carrying all the kills for the blue team. So I'm about to run out on this bout. And there's time. And pretty obviously, the red team is the winner. The bosses, they win, and they're going to move on to face Team Hyrule in the second round. Let's take a look at the stats. Oh, Charlie did get one kill, but again, most of the majority killing for the blue team done by Captain Falcon. He also died less. 5-3 for Boozer, 6-4 for Captain Ganon. That is a pretty good performance by the bosses. Now on to the third bout, which we have between the 7 seed and the 10 seed. I'm actually looking very forward to this one. With the 7 team, we have the 7 seed team. We have the oldies, which consists of Dr. Nine, Mr. Game & Watch, and Duck Hunt Dead. The Duck Hunt Dog looks both of these guys are pretty old. I'll say that for sure. We'll put them both on the green team just because of that. They're going to be pairing them up against the BRUHS. The BRUHS, because it is me and DP Man, actually. Amiibos, these, based off of how we fight. Yes, it's true. We have me, Death Stamina, rocking the Swordsman. We have DP Man, rocking the Brawler. Just for, to keep it easy for us, we're going to put both of us on the blue team. It's going to be very interesting to see how we do it. This one's going to be very close. This one's going to be on stage, and it's going to be Bridge of Elden. You're going to get to take a look and see what our Miis look like, kind of. See me over there with the Shy Guy mask. And DP Man trying to make his Mii look as derpy as possible. Well, not as derpy as possible, but as serious as possible. The exact opposite of derpy. And again, Mario had to completely remove all the seriousness. I think it's going to be very interesting to see how this works, especially with, my character has a lot of attack and defense, not a lot of speed, and just spams a lot. A lot of spam. And then DP Man's Mii likes to run in there and just mess around. Kick some butt. Right now, pretty close battle, honestly. DP Man up to 200 damage already. He's doing a good job of blasting. Oh! Duck Hunt Daggett getting the first kill there, and I'm not going to be able to quite recover either. So Duck Hunt Daggett getting two kills immediately for the oldies. It wouldn't disappoint me if we lost, but I mean, we have a chance to beat them. Of course, you never know what to expect from Duck Hunt Daggett and Doc 9. These guys are a little ridiculous. I'm not being spammy as I usually am. Very surprising to see that. Oh, I got a kill right there. And DP Man, well, DP Man got killed there by Dr. 9. Of naming these guys, I just thought, well, in my opinion, I just thought, no, I'm not going to name it Deffy the Fourth, because that would just be kind of stupid. This Mii actually is like a representation of how I fight, so why not? Oh, and then it's like, I get killed there by Dr. 9, that's very fitting. And then DP Man, he just wanted his, of course, to be kind of like related to his, so he also gave his after. That was a nice attack by DP Man to kill Dr. 9 there. Armies representing how we actually fight. DP Man Jr., of course, is kind of similar, but not quite how we want our fighting styles to be. And of course, Deffy Jr., Deffy the Third, kind of similar to mine as well, but not quite what I want them to be, of course. Man, I look out. It hit DP Man. Oh, nice attack by DP Man there. After a tough start for me and DP Man, our team is actually kind of looking kind of close to these guys. Especially with DP Man doing some kills pretty much. Edge guard is real for both of us. Oh, nice attack there by DP Man. That's going to really hurt Dr. 9. I did not quite recover from that. It's kind of my recovery is kind of similar to Ike's, but DP Man Jr., or DP Man, got a kill on Dr. 9 again. But yeah, my recovery is kind of like, that was a nice kill there by Duck Hunt Dag. Yeah, my recovery is kind of like, similar to Ike's, but it doesn't have the horizontal reach. DP Man's horizontal recovery and vertical recovery are both pretty good. Only less than a minute left already in this fight, and Dr. Nine almost got a kill there, but Duck and Dead was grabbed him right afterwards, but Dr. Nine went ahead and finished off the kill. Oh, and Duck Hunt Dag pull off too far to the edge. He's gonna die right there. Attack sends TP Man up in the air. Less than 30 seconds now. Oh, and a nicely timed attack by Dr. Nine. He's actually not doing a bad job right now. Dr. Nine is, that is. This is one of his better performances since the first Amiibo tournament. I'm about to find out the results here. That one was pretty close. But the oldies are going to win it. Dr. Nine doing some more work there. That was a very good job by both of them. Let's look at the stats here. Positive 3 to negative 3. Deep Man did a lot more killing than I did, but we both died at the same amount of times. Dr. Nine went 4-2. Duck Hunt Dag did a good job, though, with 4-3. So both of them did a really good job. The oldies are going to move on to the second round, whereas me and DP Man have been eliminated. Maybe we just weren't meant to be paired together as a team. Oh well. Well, anyway, we've got our fourth and final match for this episode here, and it's a pretty exciting one. We got, of course, the townspeople who won in their last round, or in the first episode in like a preliminary match. They moved on. Mr. Rogers and another one. They defeated the annoying brats of Jigglypuff and Diddy Kong to move on. We're going to put them on the... we'll put them on the green team. That'll be fine. And they're going to be facing off against a team that got a bye in last round. And I actually wanted this team to be the one seed, but I guess it kind of makes sense to put them as the two seed. It is your good old Mario Brothers. We got Super Mario and a Super Luigi. They're going to be the red team because Mario is the better Mario Bro, at least in terms of the Amiibo stats. So we're going to put them on the red team against the Mr. Rogers and another one, green team. We're going to pick out a stage. That stage is going to be Congo Jungle 64. It's kind of a Mario stage, not really. Same dimension. It'll be very interesting to see how this works. I think Super Mario being paired with Super Luigi allows Super Luigi to bring out his very best when he competes in tag team matches. Luigi always seems to be better in a tag team match. But right now, another one doing a lot of work to mess around, and he's not messing around here against these Mario Bros. These Mario Bros are just some fools to him. He's going to kill Super Luigi. And the townspeople are actually going to get the first kill. This could be a very good upset right here if the townspeople can win. Another one isn't a bad fighter, and Mr. Rogers can hold his own occasionally too. There goes Mr. Rogers up into the air. This ice ball is going to really help with Luigi. He's going to get the first kill for the red team eliminating Mr. Rogers. This really looks like it's going to be a close fight between another one and Super Mario to see who's going to be kind of balancing each other out. Luigi and Mr. Rogers are going to kind of play the support role, whereas another one and Super Mario are going to kind of just see who can take the lead. Good recovery there by another one. There he goes. Mario went up high in the sky there, but he's still alive. And Luigi, gonna get another kill. Luigi is starting to bring out all of his abilities right now. He's got both kills so far. Mario's been racking up the damage for the team, and Luigi's going in for the kill. Certainly a strategy you could use. Luigi has some pretty good smash attacks for kills. Just let Mario kind of rack up the damage, and there goes Mario, eliminated by Mr. Rogers. But Mario gonna immediately kill Mr. Rogers right back on the respawn. There's a broken shield for Luigi. Another one barely gonna survive, and Mr. Rogers gonna send Luigi going. This is a pretty good fight, actually, for these two. I was expecting it to be a lot further away, but it is a pretty exciting fight. That was a good attack right there. Mario and Luigi both landing hits on Mr. Rogers. So close, Luigi. You almost had it. Oh, there goes Mr. Rogers, eliminated by Luigi. I don't know what it is about these tag team matches, but Luigi always gets so much better when he's playing tag team. And there goes Luigi, eliminated by Mr. Rogers again. Luigi almost got Mr. Rogers right back, though. Yeah, Thunder's gonna do some damage to Mario. Those ice balls have been really helping out Luigi, especially with freezing up the momentum. Oh, that's gonna hurt. Luke is trying to land a PK freeze right there. Couldn't quite get it to work. He's gonna recover with PK Thunder, though. It's always ridiculous to see the circus recovery. Another one. He lived up to 330 and he's still living. That's pretty crazy. Tried to go up with the taunt kick right there at the edge. That would have been kind of funny had he landed it. Whoa! That ice ball just sent Lucas into the sky with that amount of damage he has. And there goes Lucas off to one side. Mr. Rogers is not quite eliminated on the other side. 1.5 minutes left. Okay, Freeze almost hits Mario, just a little too high. The combo is there by Rogers and another one. With his amazing recovery. And there goes Mr. Rogers, but there goes Mario as well. Luigi's still alive. That amazing recovery is just ridiculous. Oh, but another one's gonna kill him right as he lands back on the stage. Upset alert right here. Under a minute left, and I have no idea who's actually gonna win this one. I wanna say it's the Mario Bros, but townspeople have been doing a good job on their own. Mr. Rogers getting slung up a little bit. Another one goes up into the sky. And there goes Mr. Rogers, eliminated by Super Luigi. Okay, Freeze almost hitting Luigi, but he grabbed onto the edge to get the invincibility. And there goes another one eliminated by Super Mario. PK Freeze almost hits Mario again in the process of dodging. Time's about to run out in the match. And that is the end of regular time. And the Mario Bros are going to edge out this victory. Very good job, and Luigi is in the front. Look at that, Luigi. Must have done a really good job. Let's go with the stats. 6! Kills for Super Luigi. That is a great performance. Mario kind of just went in and took the support role, doing a lot of damage, and Luigi with his amazing smash attacks would finish it off. Another one went 3-3, and Mr. Rogers went 3-5. So another one did slightly better, in at least the terms of not getting killed as much. Well, that is the end of the first half of the first round. I'm gonna do another episode right after this to get to the second half of the first round, so we can kind of see that full second round completed. It's going to be very interesting to see these next set of matches, because I think this next set of matches, after seeing these ones, is going to be just as exciting. So we'll see who else is going to be joining Team Hyrule, the Bosses, who else? Oh yeah, the Oldies, and the Mario Bros. So that's going to be, we're going to see who else is going to join those four teams. But that's going to do it for this episode. I've been Def Stamina. Thank you guys so much for watching, and I will see you guys in the next episode. Bye-bye!